Hi, my name is Hiroshi Mori from National Institute of Genetics in Mishima. Today I'm going to talk about some use case to integrate the microbial genome and metagenome data using semantic web technology. Our database calls microbeDB.jp. As you know, and Pierre already described that our planet Earth is consisted of many microbes, and they inhabit almost everywhere on Earth and interact with their environments. For example, our skin and our gut and your laptops, keyboard, they exist. But unfortunately, we cannot see them because they are too tiny. But we can analyze these microbes using, for example, a metagenomic technique or a genomic technique. And many microbial researchers are already sequencing many environment and many genomes of microbes. And this knowledge can be used for the other research field researchers, for example, the agriculture or any kind of the architecture or any kind of the commercial applications. But this data is stored in many databases. Each database is very good for these applications. But if you want to use these data, and if you are not familiar with the microbes, in that case, the choice of database is really difficult. So we integrated this data set for one database called microbeDB.jp. That project was started in 2011. And we integrated a lot of data related to microbes, especially for the microbial data can be linked to the genome, because genome information is very basic to describe microbial ecology or microbial phenotypes. And we use many ontology to link to microbial gene, and microbial taxon, and microbial environment from the sources there. And our project is now version 3, and I am a member of the project, but the boss is Professor Ken Crocker from our laboratory. And they are National Institute of Genetics, and National Institute of Basic Biology, and Tokyo Institute of Technology, and Chiba University. There are four institutes is representative to develop microbeDB.jp. And this green font means that in this hackathon, they are participate and develop some kind of the data. For example, Chiba-san now in DBCLS, he is an expert in orthodox. And Suzuki-san from Tokyo Institute of Technology, he is also expert for microbial ecology ontology. And also technical advisor, because our database is fully algorithmized. And so the technical, many technical advancement is necessary, and they these technical advancement is very important to describe our data set. So the DBCLS, especially for Kawashima-san and Katayama-san, is the technical advisor of our databases. And funding is JST and NBDC. And our database is so describing many kinds of the microbial-related data. So we integrate these data using RDF technologies. Almost all know the RDF data technology. But we also need to develop many kind of the microbial-related ontologies, because our project started in 2011. In that time, the ontology-related microbes is not so much exist. So we developed, for example, MEO, that is microbes metagenomic environment ontology. That is related, that is a little bit similar to the environment ontology, but that is sometimes somehow different from environment ontology. And also we describe many kind of other ontology. And most of ontology can be downloaded in bioportal. For example, MEO. Now that is version 0.8. That describes microbial environment. That is sometimes different from our environment. For example, human intestine is our organ, but in case of microbes, that is environment. So the semantically it is different. Therefore, we describe and we developed meal that is for microbes, not for us. And we describe some of the environment in us, on us, and also some environmental component, the environmental state, and the environmental position. Now the class is more than 2,000, and the relationships of the class is described not so, not only the hierarchical structure, but also the relationships between, for example, organism association and human activity association. So the topic is more than the 3 point, larger than the class size. And developing these ontologies and retrieving data from the many kind of the already developed the databases from other groups, we developed the microbeDB.jp. And this red means we developed that ontology with our databases. And we obtained these, for example, microbial genome from RESTEC prokaryotes and microbial metagenomic data from INCGC DRA. But if only retrieving these data, still they are not so linked. So first, we use the URI mapping, that is using, for example, orthologous data protein ID and genome protein ID. That is same URI, so you can easily to connect. But still there are some discrepancies between the data set. So the ontology manual annotation is necessary. For example, this one, using MEL, we can link to culture collection strain data and metagenomic data, and also microbial genome data and metagenomic data link to, because of the they are, both of them are, for example, isolated from soil, so we can link using the MEL. But still there are, for example, metagenome and also cannot link. So we used the sequence-based integration because gene has the DNA sequence and genome have the DNA sequence. Also the metagenome have DNA sequence. So we can conduct sequence similarity search of the metagenomic data to the genome, and we can link using sequence data, and also genome, the each genes in the genome can be clustering, can be conducting clustering using also clustering. We can link between genome. So our strategy is based on the ontology-based integration and also sequence-based integration. But in metagenomic data, already the several 0.6 or 0.7 million samples already exist in INCGC DRA. So we downloaded all of the sequence data and conducted the same analysis pipeline and analyzed the taxonomic composition of the sample and also functional composition of the sample using this pipeline, using NRG supercomputer. And because of this, using same pipeline, we can compare between samples from other researchers' data. So after analyzing sequence-based analysis, we can link to the metagenomic data to the taxon, and also metagenomic data to the authors. Also, using other pipelines, we can link to RNA-seq data to the genomes. After using ID mapping and ontology manual annotation and sequence-based analysis, we can link to the many kind of heterogeneous microbial data using that, and to this, to using these workflows, we developed the MicrobeDB for all of data described in RDF, and that is the 20, the version 1 in 2012, that is 1 billion total, that is 1 billion RDF tuples. But in version 2, that is last year's version, that is already the 9 billion data set, 9 billion RDF. And we store this in batches in single server, but it's almost, in single server, it's very difficult to handle this 9 billion data set. And these RDF data that we can search using this text search interfaces. The address is this, already that is opened. But searching RDF data using text search, it needs some development of the applications called stanza. That is basically it is developed from Toshiaki-san and also Kawashima-san from DBCLS, and we use this Togo stanza framework to search, because each user only they use the web browser and keyword search, and if keyword search is if keyword are specified, we can search this keyword using the specifying each stanza ID, and that stanza is encoded some Sparkle query, and using that keyword we can search RDF databases using that Sparkle query. After that, we retrieve some stats data, and using that stats, we visualize it. That stats data using the JavaScript and HTML. And already, we developed the over 130 standards to describe microbial data. For example, that is the gene annotation data, and also list, and this table structure data. We also can present that using each this particle is a standard. And also the using JavaScript library, we can visualize this kind of graph and also this kind of a table. Or you can use some metagenomic comparisons using these graphs. But each standard is some types, because if you search some keyword, but the integrated databases contain many kinds of data. So we already have more than 130 stanza. It means that if we don't specify any kind of the stanza list, we need to simultaneously need to search more than 130 Sparkle query simultaneously. It is very difficult. So we need to define each stanza type. For example, this stanza is the environment, and this stanza is the gene type, and this stanza is the metagenomic type. To define that, we can easily manage the keyword using each, without in environment. In case of environment, we can use a meal ontology. In case of taxon, we can use NSPI taxonomy. And in case of gene function, we can use the product name in ISDC. And in case of phenotype, microbial phenotype, we can use NPO. After the inference of the, after searching the keyword to that ontology, we can specify the, that term is the type of the, that term. In case of hot string, that is type of the environment. So only we can describe the stand, we can search stanza in type of the environment. So this is efficiently searching the many kind of the heterogeneous keyword using this system. So MicrobeDB is our main technology. Component is that, of course, there are all of the data is described in RDF, and most of the knowledge can be described in ontology related to the microbes. But the only RDF data from the already published data, but most of the data need to reanalyze to more efficiently link. So we developed some analysis pipeline to summarize and comparison between data. And also to visualize data, we need to develop the stanza. And all of the MicrobeDB data can be downloaded from here. And now we are developing MicrobeDB version 3. And there are still 30 seconds, so we can demonstrate. This is MicrobeDB. You can search, for example, in English, C. So the C is for the environment, so this is already automatically typed to the environment, but also they see have some synonymous, and if there are environment, the sees definitions and sees metagenomic sample list and the average taxonomic composition of C. Yeah. And also the functional composition of C, yes, this is a carbon metabolism. Or functional composition between the near the neighbor of the environment. And we have to see the neighbor of the lake environment. So this we can compare it to the functional composition. And yes, this kind of the data integration we can perform using the semantic wave technologies. Okay, thank you very much.